First, let us agree that this one, all these pillars, is not one block of stone. Those looks like tablets or gears on the top of each others. Okay? Small rounded shapes, taking the same shape and the design they like it. So let us say, from here to here, it will be like one piece, another piece, a third one, a fourth one, and so on. So what they do is, they make the base, the foundation, and then surrounding each one of those, they got like a wall. And this wall, like a room surrounded, they fill it with sand. And they put the next piece of stone. They are using the sand as ramp to push the stone on the top of it until it reaches to its own level. While it is so down like that, the first or the second level, it's easy to control the stones. But when we are talking about the one on the top there, they need a lift, and they don't have a lift in that time. So they make like a ramp made out of sand and mud and push the stone on the body of those ramps until it reaches to the top. And then each one of those tablets or those calendar, they have like a hole in the middle. And they put like one piece of stone all the way down from the base till the top to keep those pieces of stones together and tie them together. And then they are using a mortar to fix between the stones. And this mortar is a powder of the same material of the stone. So if they are working with limestone like here, the powder, the mortar, it is actually a powder of limestone mixed with some glue and some water. They don't have cement, they don't have concrete as we have nowadays. And then after they are sure it's going all the way up to the right, to the top, and it's erected shape, is not 100% right, it's not knee leaning to any one of the both sides, they start to put the ceiling on the top. And the ceiling is beams of stones, each beam connecting between two different pillars. By this way, the base keeps the pillars from down and the ceiling keeps the pillars from up. After they are sure everything is right, they start to remove the sand from the top to down, and they start to mix the reliefs and colors on the top of the body of the pillar itself. That is the way how they do it. When we dig in this area, exactly in this location, underneath this place, or something like 25 feet under the ground, they discover a hole, and they discover 27 statues were hidden under the ground. What happened is, when an invasion come to Egypt, the people or the high priestess who are in charge of this temple, they were afraid that those invaders and those enemies who come to attack Egypt, they will take the statues and destroy it. And the statue keeps the face picture of the king. If his statue missing or his face missing, he will have no second life. And also they got some treasures, some golden statues, statues covered with gold, statues made out of priceless stones, and that's why they need to keep it. And that's why they were thinking the best way to keep something is under the mattress, under the ground. So they make a hole under the ground and they keep the things inside. What happened is, when the invasion survived for a long time and the occupation survived for a long time, the story of the location where they keep the things under the ground became a secret, and nobody know where it is, and they forget about it, or the information missing, and by this way it's waiting for us to be discovered. That's why everywhere we go in Egypt, we didn't only dig on the normal places, we always expecting that we could find things hidden everywhere, even inside the walls itself. Day after tomorrow, we are going to visit a temple we call the Komombo. And I will let you see a safe under the ground and inside the wall. Nobody could think that there is a safe inside this wall, but we find and discover one, and there is some treasures was inside. When I say treasures, it doesn't always mean it's gold or silver or money or wealth things. Sometimes those treasures are treasures of information, scrolls of papyrus paper, giving us some information about those ancient people. This way.